The right to grow old with dignity. It's long been recognised that our elderly need and deserve our support. The first pension was brought in 125 years ago. But times change. KiwiSaver was introduced because, for many of us, the pension is not enough. But what of those who haven't been able to save, who don't own their own home, who can't make ends meet in retirement? As we grapple with the cost of living crisis, Connor Whitten meets the elderly wanting to do more than just survive.
The clock hasn't yet struck 4 a.m. And Warwick Price is off to work.
Why are you still working at 81?
I just love what I'm doing. But the primary reason is I love travelling. And if I wasn't working, I couldn't afford to travel.
All aboard.
Yeah.
Warwick drives a truck from Rotorua to Kawera.
How do you like the early starts?
Oh, I love it.
The cargo? Treated human waste. Poo.
It is a horrendous smell, isn't it? No doubt about that.
It's not glamorous work, is it?
No, it's not glamorous, but I don't dive into it.
Warwick's shift finishes just after sunrise. It's the same routine 3 days a week.
The pension is nowhere near enough to live on. I keep working because I couldn't afford not to and have the lifestyle I have.
Would you still eat 3 square meals a day?
I doubt it. Doubt it.
It puts food on the table, but it isn't retirement. And not every pensioner can work.
How much is your pension?
How much do I get in my pocket? In this pocket? You want to know dollar for dollar?
Natalie Lambert is 66. She retired early, but not by choice.
I was a chef. I had my own business, 35 years, working in that field of hospitality.
Until she suffered multiple health problems.
What impact did that have on you?
You're left with absolutely nothing when you have to be put off medically.
She also lost her husband 20 years ago.
So now you're trying to get by on the pension. How difficult is that?
How difficult is it to find a dollar to get a bottle of milk? Bloody hard, excuse my language. I just don't know how to put it into words. The feeling that your guts has been pulled out from you.
It's been a while since Natalie had a sous chef.
You want me to peel the onion as well?
What do you want me to do?
No, I won't let you cry at this stage. Would you cry?
I probably would, yeah. If you've got any tricks to avoid that, you let me know.
But where she once cooked to make her money,
yeah.
Now she has to do it to save.
I'm making a vegetable bake, and you just layer your vegetables.
So how much do you think this dish would cost you altogether?
If I wasn't using potatoes in that from my own garden, it would be $5 to $6. Today it would probably cost me about $2.
She eats cheaply and less often.
I go without. I don't have a big meal now, and that's good for me, but I've learnt to cut down. I've had to cut down. One meal a day.
One meal a day?
One meal a day. When it's on that tough week where you've got your power and your water rates, which is all this week, and your rent all going out at the same time, you don't have 2 or 3 meals a day.
But Natalie's biggest expense is housing. Like 1 in 5 other super annuitants, Natalie doesn't own a property, so she rents her Tauranga home.
How much do you have to pay for rent?
I was paying $450 per week. And that has now gone up to $520 per week.
How hard is it to find an extra $70?
Extremely hard.
The pension did increase on April 1st by about $34 a week for a single person living alone. But research shows, on average, a no-frills retirement in a major city costs around $300 more than that each week.
Your mum's told us sometimes she only eats one meal a day. What is it like to hear that?
It's really upsetting.
Something
Rena is Natalie's only child.
Change it to clubs.
You bugger.
Yes.
My daughter's a strong woman and she has a big heart. She's the love of my life. Yeah.
I feel like I can't do enough to support her. I feel like, as a family, have we not thought of the right things along the way? I feel like the government has kind of let us down in a way as well. She's basically surviving rather than enjoying that moment.
40-year-old Rena helps her mum when she can, but Natalie values her independence and worries Rena does too much.
Do you have anything else this week?
I personally feel that it stopped her from having a family. And that's a big responsibility that she has put on my shoulders. Because I don't want to have to hold them back in any way.
You're worried about being a burden?
Yep. Very much so.
I think subconsciously it's actually had a real impact on me. Because in a way you feel like you have a dependent. So having a family, having children, how would that actually work with the responsibility I have to my mum?
More and more of our seniors are struggling. 40% of retired New Zealanders have to get by on the pension alone. And that number is worse for women. In Natalie's age bracket, it's nearly half, compared to a third of men. The legacy of a lifelong gender pay gap. Fewer hours in work for lower wages, says Kiwi women retire with less.
The people who are least well off in this space are women, Māori and Pacifica.
Retirement Commissioner Jane Wrightson.
And they're all for different reasons. It's certainly not because they're stupid and can't save.
This is my budget book and I use this for my pension. I've got rent every fortnight and I pay my power-to-power shop. I've got a funeral account and put $5 a week into that.
Marie Stanley's learned to manage her money, down to the very last dollar and cent.
How much is left this fortnight after paying all of the bills?
I think it worked out to $1.86, and that's got to last me now until the next pension.
It's pretty tight, isn't it?
Very tight. Very tight.
She worked hard to raise two boys on her own.
Worked as a cleaner to start with, just to get money. Worked as a teacher aide so that I could be there school holidays and when they went to college. I started working full time.
Were you able to save anything for your retirement?
I had about $5,000 saved, but I found that the pension is not quite enough when things go wrong. You can survive on it, but you can't live on it. And so that money disappeared.
Today, living in East Auckland, Marie relies on social housing. At 70, she's never owned her own home.
Where do you think you'd be if you weren't in social housing?
I would probably be homeless, to be brutally honest. I really would.
Rent comes first, food last.
Oh, that looks like it's dead.
I thought, I really feel like a piece of fish. I really, really do. So I went to Pack and Save and they wanted $12.95 for it. And I just stood there and it was the cheapest piece of fish they had in the cabinet. And I could feel myself starting to cry because I just couldn't afford a piece of fish.
How does that make you feel?
It makes me feel like I don't count anymore. It makes me feel like I'm not managing my money enough. And it makes me feel like I can't afford to eat healthy anymore. Yeah, that's how it makes me feel.
And as for the dentist,
I found that as I was getting older, it was easier and cheaper to let your tooth abscess and get it pulled out than it was to get it filled. It was half the price, and that's why I ended up with no teeth.
She wasn't eligible for government help for dentures, so had to borrow the money from her son.
If you've got to walk around with no teeth in, it's humiliating. It's absolutely humiliating.
Her pension's gone up, but so have the bills.
They always put things up within a fortnight to 3 weeks of getting that pay increase. I got an email to say that my line charges were going up, and it's not a big sum, but you've got to find that.
And that means making cuts elsewhere.
Power, I'm very stingy. If I'm going to cook, I put it on between 11 and 4, which is when I get slightly cheaper power.
Do you get cold in winter?
Oh, it's freezing in this house in winter. It's freezing. I just go to bed if I'm cold. Other ways I save money is going to second-hand shops. This one, which I really love, was $3, brand spanking new.
Every dollar counts and nothing is wasted, thanks to a bit of DIY. These free offcuts will become planter boxes for tomatoes she can grow but can't afford to buy.
I think that there are thousands of us out there who are going through this every single day. We're not all rich baby boomers. It's not just about child poverty, there's aged poverty as well.
Many seniors suffer in silence, but we spoke to a number of others, all with difficult choices to make.
Sometimes I have to sit in the dark because of saving my expenses.
As it is, I survive mostly on two-minute noodles. The days of having veggies every week and that have gone.
I don't flush my toilet and it saves about $10 or $12 a month.
NZ Super is to alleviate pensioner poverty. We have people who are poor, sure, but not at the extreme end, generally speaking. We don't have pensioners starving on the streets.
We've met pensioners for this story who were homeless, people who eat only one meal a day. Are you sure that there's no pension poverty in New Zealand?
Clearly not.
Does that worry you?
Yes, of course it does. Are they too proud to ask, or is there a gap in the system? I'd like to know more about that.
Coming up, from living in a car...
It's a crisis point.
..to flatting with mates, and how retirement could change for you.
So are you fighting for that?
Yes.
Waking up by the shore at Mount Maunganui. It's the postcard retirement dream. But away from the beach, the Bay of Plenty doesn't live up to its name for some.
We've already seen one elderly man living in this park this morning. How big is the need out there?
Oh, the need is huge. It's phenomenal. We have 80-year-olds living in conditions like this.
Social worker Sylvia Wilson helps the homeless in Tauranga, increasingly those over 65.
It can make you cry some days, if I'm being really truthful. It's a crisis point, and there's no homes. So what do you do? And that's what we're trying to do with Wharepatariki, is to create that home for those elderly. I've got some eggs for you.
Thank you.
Inside an old doctor's clinic.
What are you guys cooking for dinner tonight?
An unlikely group of flatmates share the cooking and cleaning.
Don't forget tomorrow. You have an appointment tomorrow.
Wharepatariki houses the homeless. Six men in their 60s, 70s and 80s living together under one roof.
After two or three days in the whare, there's a smile, there's lovely clean water to wash and a warm, safe bed, beautiful food to eat. There's kinship and a place to call home.
It's named after Patrick, a local homeless pensioner who died in transitional housing. He lay there for days before he was found.
Because our old people shouldn't be living alone out there, and a lot of them do. And a lot of them die just like Patrick.
The idea of the whare is that no one else dies alone.
Exactly. Exactly. I mean, isn't that the purpose of human existence? Is that we are connected?
This whare can only house elderly men. They'd like to set up more, and for women too.
Our whare, Wharepatariki, it's full. I have a waiting list. I have agencies ringing. Is there any vacancies at Wharepatariki? No, I'm sorry, there's not.
With rent subsidised and food included, it supports residents until they're ready to find somewhere more permanent, if they can find it.
We need hundreds of them. We really, really do, because things aren't like they were yesteryear. We're in a different world today. Very challenging world.
NZ Super is predicated on either you owning your own home outright, meaning you've got quite low housing costs, or you have affordable public housing. We've got the lowest home ownership rate since 1953 at the moment. This problem is going to get worse before it gets better. The housing market's not ready to deal with that, and the NZ Super settings aren't ready to deal with that either. We're thinking that by about 2048, there'll be about 600,000 pensioners renting, which means you've got to factor this into housing policy. We're not building the right kind of houses, and if people think they're just going to trade down their family home, the question is what to?
81-year-old Warwick counts himself lucky. He has a roof over his head, a job 3 days a week.
Where are we taking it to, Polly?
And volunteers at St John for another two.
Here we are.
Warwick has always kept himself busy.
Here we are, Polly. You right there?
I've never been unemployed for longer than maybe 2 or 3 weeks.
So how many years of your life have you worked?
Since 16. I started at 16, I'm 81. You figure that out.
That's 65 years, but it didn't set him up for retirement.
I've worked all my life and for a long time I had nothing to show for it.
He worked to support his family. A father to four, Warwick's now a grandfather of five and a great-granddad too. But he's no longer in the family home. It was sold when his marriage broke up.
I don't have a mortgage. The last thing I need is a mortgage at my age. I would never in my wildest dreams would I be able to pay off a mortgage, particularly at today's prices.
So he started renting at 75.
I'm very lucky that I'm able to work and earn good money. I've been able to add to my term deposit. There's no way I could even put $10 in if I was just living on the pension. Simple as that.
We should be given the dignity to be allowed to have some savings at our back, to use how we want to use it. We earned that right.
They also don't want to be penalised. Pensioners who rely on the accommodation supplement can't have more than $8,100 in the bank.
It's too low. It's based on a beneficiary system, if you like, that you have to deplete all your assets before you access the accommodation supplement. That's not a good policy basis for seniors. You want to encourage them to keep their assets so that they can continue to live in a way that suits them. But if they have high accommodation costs or high rental costs, they can seek additional support.
The Retirement Commissioner says the savings limit should be five times higher, nearly $43,000. Jenny Anderson is the Minister for Seniors.
That's something I think has been taken into consideration at the moment, looking at the affordability of that. While I don't hold a budget for seniors, my job is to go and talk to my colleagues like the Minister of Health, Minister of Housing, to get the best possible outcome for seniors, and I'm really passionate about doing that.
I understand that. So are you fighting for that?
Yes.
What would you say to the pensioners who've spoken to us for this story, who say they feel forgotten, who say that they barely have enough right now to survive?
It's difficult, I acknowledge that. I meet people regularly who are struggling. The supports we've given by increasing superannuation by over $100 for a couple and by over $60 for a single, that's the biggest single jump we've seen.
They're telling us right now that it isn't enough.
I hear that.
They are frightened to hear what's actually going on out there.
You feel ignored?
Yeah, I do. I wonder if it's worthwhile being alive, and death doesn't frighten me. That worries me at times, because it's an easy way out. But I think of those that are left.
Your daughter?
Yeah. Last card. Me personally, I feel that if you don't say something now, I would regret it for the rest of my life.
It takes real guts to do that. So yeah, I'm proud of you. Don't start crying.
I'm pretty near, don't start crying.
For those on the breadline, hope comes in small doses. And for Marie, it comes coin by coin.
This is my money box for small goals. And at the moment, this money is to be saved for block-out curtains for my bedroom. So I just put loose change in. Sometimes I'm lucky enough to find it on the footpath and I put it in my pocket and come home, put it in here.
Marie finally opened a savings account at age 62. She's been growing it slowly ever since.
I've got $5,006 in my bank account.
And what's that going to?
I am going to my son's wedding in America.
How do you feel about that?
Oh, really excited. I'm over the moon. I haven't seen him for 8 years.
How much work has gone into saving that money?
7 years. 7 years scrounging money out of the groceries. If I got ahead on the power, not having to pay power one fortnight, put that into the bank, and I am going to enjoy spending it. I've waited a long time. There it is, just out there.
Earlier this month, she set off with her grandson, Ryan.
It'll be worth it.
It will be worth it. 35 days. I've got 35 days with him.
Warwick is also looking forward to the future. Age concern drew his name from a ballot, offering him a place in a new tiny home.
So, Warwick, which one of these would be yours?
Ideally, that one.
He's still weighing up the offer. It would mean greater travel costs, but cheaper rent, and a heat pump instead of a fire to keep him warm.
There's no insulation in this place. It's a concrete floor. You either freeze or cook in here.
Either way.
You're going to keep working?
Of course. Of course I'm going to keep working. I'm not in any hurry to retire.
Clearly not.
3 days after Marie walked through airport security, she walked her son down the aisle in California. A moment of joy that didn't come easy after 7 years of saving and going without.
I know that we're getting this money from the government and that taxpayers are paying for it, but I paid my taxes too.
Natalie finds solace in simple pleasures.
Good dog.
But she'd like to do more than just survive.
I still want to be independent. I don't want to have to rely on my family to do all those things for me.
Did you think a lot about retirement when you were younger?
No. I never thought I would live to as old as I am.
The stability of the retirement income framework system is the key to me.
How much money should people be saving for retirement?
If you're able to put away 5 or 10% of your first pay packet and continue doing that, you'll set yourself up very well.
Because they're present. What do you miss the most?
To be able to afford to sit down to 3 meals a day and not worry about what you're having to eat.
Is a warning for the future.
If these youngsters of today don't start saving now, they're going to be in big trouble. You've got to save for the future.
And then you don't have to live scrounging for what you get. Yeah.
Well, last year, the Retirement Commission made 24 recommendations to improve the well-being of seniors. They're still waiting for a government response.